Daydreaming versus visualizing. What's the difference between these two? Is there even a difference between these two? This is a question that I hear about all the time. And it's understandable to get these two confused because they do have a lot of similarities between them. So today we're going to talk about this. We're going to talk about daydreaming and visualizing. So if you are curious to learn more, if you are having stumbling blocks because of this, then definitely be sure to stick around and watch this video because we're going to do a deep dive into daydreaming versus visualization. What is up, you guys? I am Missy Renee, and in today's video, we're going to talk about daydreaming versus visualizing when it comes to manifesting your desires. So, if manifestation and conscious creation are topics that you are interested in learning more about, then definitely be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that way you're notified when I come out with new content every week. If you're interested in more resources such as one-on-one coaching, I will leave the link to that down in the description box below, along with some other resources that will be super helpful, so definitely be sure to check them out. So I've actually wanted to make a video about this for quite some time now, and the main reason is because this is something that confuses a lot of people when we're new to this. Daydreaming and visualizing sound very, very similar, and it's easy to get the two of them mixed up, but there is a very clear distinction between the two. And it's important to understand this because I was making a detrimental mistake when I was new. So I want to be sure that you guys know exactly going forward how to know that you're doing this correctly. So be sure to stick around to the end because I'm going to give you guys some helpful tips as to how you can make sure that you are visualizing correctly, that you're doing this in a way that is going to yield the results. But just a really quick announcement before we get started. I want to let you guys know about my upcoming membership group, the Conscious Creator Society. I've decided that every month I'm going to be doing a live workshop going over a number of different manifestation topics, and I also decided I wanted to take it a step further. And I wanted to start to build a community of like-minded people, of like-minded creators who can be there for each other, support each other, help each other out. Share your success stories and overall encourage each other along the way. And not only is this membership a community, but it's also packed full of a bunch of helpful resources for you guys. Along with the monthly workshop, you'll also have access to all of my previous recorded workshops. I'll be doing live Q&As where you'll get the chance to ask me questions about your specific topic, along with a ton of other helpful resources such as guided meditations, workbooks, guide sheets, inspirational graphics, and so much more. I will have the link down in the description box below for more information, so definitely be sure to check it out. And I'm also going to be running a special for the next 30 days where if you sign up, you will get 50% off your membership costs for life. So again, check it out in the description below. Definitely be sure to sign up, and I will see you guys there. So let's just dive right in. So first off, are daydreaming and visualizing the same thing? Well, the short answer is no. They are not the same thing. Although there is similarities, there are some very distinct differences that are super important to be aware of because this could be the distinction between your success and your failure. And in fact, for a very, very long time, I was making this mistake and I was getting frustrated as to why I wasn't really seeing the results and why things weren't happening in a way that I wanted them to or would have expected. And the distinct difference really boils down to that when you're daydreaming, you're not actually occupying that state. And what I mean is, instead of occupying, you're just observing your scene or your state. Now, if you watch my channel, or if you're a follower of Neville Goddard, then you know that we manifest by moving ourselves into a state or a reality or dimension, whatever you want to call it, but we move ourselves into a state where our desire already exists. So we have to go and embody that version of us that we desire to be. But when we're daydreaming, we're not fully embodying that scene or that desire. We're just observing it. When we daydream, we're just observers. We're just observing it. We're not actually in that scene. We're not actually putting ourselves in that state. So there is still that disconnect. There's still that feeling of separation and longing for whatever it is that you're imagining or daydreaming about. And a really, really common mistake that I see a lot of people make when they're new at this, and this is what I was screwing up with when I was new, is that instead of actually putting themselves in their scene, instead of actually living in that end, in that desired event, you're not occupying the state because you're looking at it like it's something that's going to happen in the future. Because a lot of the mindset that people have when they're new at this is, okay, if I imagine this thing, then it's going to eventually happen, when that's not the correct mentality that you should be taking into this. So instead of visualizing or imagining in the state akin to sleep, you're just effectively daydreaming, because we kind of look at this visualization like it's a fantasy of something way off in the future. We visualize to basically feel like that different person in the future compared to the now version of ourselves. And for me, I was especially doing this. I was visualizing my end scene. I was visualizing myself and the wish fulfilled, but it didn't feel like the me right here, right now. It felt like the future me, the far off distant me, almost like the person that I was in this event was like the more evolved version of myself down the line. And this is where we get hiccups. And this is where I notice a lot of people are struggling, because this is not the visualization that you should be doing. This is daydreaming. Instead, when we visualize, we should be doing it from our desire. It is essentially the difference between thinking of something and thinking from something, which, if you don't really understand those terms and what they mean, I made a video all about it. You can check it out up here, and I'll also leave the link down in the description box below. But thinking of something versus thinking from something will be the difference between success and failure. The key with visualization is you should be actually stepping in and embodying that scene. You should be feeling like that space and time is happening right now. You're not imagining a point in the future or somewhere down the line when you finally get your SP or get all that money. No, you want to actually embody that state. You want to be that person, and it's happening right now. Make that point in the future right now. You can almost think of it like a VR simulation. I don't know how many of you have played around with VR or VR technology, but that's kind of what we are aiming for here. We want to actually put ourselves in that scene and be visualizing and experiencing it as we would be in real life if it was happening to us right now. And I'm going to give you guys another little passage from Neville to hopefully clear this up. The present moment is all important, for it is only in the present moment that our assumptions can be controlled. The future must become the present in your mind if you would wisely operate the law of assumption. The future becomes the present when you imagine that you already are what you will be when your assumption is fulfilled. Be still, least action, and know that you are that which you desire to be. The end of longing should be being. translate your dream into being. Perpetual construction of future states without the consciousness of already being them, that is, picturing your desire without actually assuming the feeling of the wish fulfilled, is the fallacy and mirage of mankind. It is simply futile daydreaming. And Neville is 100,000% correct here, because again, this was where I was getting hung up big time. And I noticed that a lot of my clients and a lot of the people that I've talked to were falling into the habit of doing the same thing. They were imagining their scene, they were seeing it in first person, they were doing all of the things that they should have been doing, but they were viewing it as if they were looking at the future version of themselves or the future version of that scenario. And that is daydreaming. That is not what you're supposed to be doing here. And a really helpful tip that will help you capture that mood and know what that feels like before you get into your SAT scene is to really sit down and ask yourself some questions. And those questions should be around, what would I be like if I was now the person that I desire to be? What would that person be like if I now had the thing that I desire to have? And really think about this before you go into SATs, before you start visualizing, before you do any of the techniques. Get familiar with what you would be feeling, what you would be thinking, what you would be saying, who would be there with you, and what would they be saying. Start to form this before you even go into that scene. Start to really ask yourself, what would this person be like if I already had my desire? Now, the next question that I get is, okay, well, how do I tell if I'm doing this right? How can I tell if my visualizations are taking an effect, or is there a way that I can determine if I'm on the right track or if I'm messing up somewhere? And the answer to this is very simple. You observe your thoughts during the day. You observe the inner conversations that you carry out throughout the day. If your thoughts and your inner conversation do not line up with your desired outcome, then you need to keep persisting. You need to keep imagining, you need to keep affirming, you need to keep with your mental diet until you notice that your thoughts and those inner convictions are matching up with your desired end. You can always look to see if you're on the right path by going within and really being the observer. Because if you're not doing this, and if you are thinking all these negative things during your day, and if you're carrying out negative conversations or arguing with yourself or arguing with your SP in your mind, then that shows that you are not in the state that you need to be in. So keep persisting if this is the case. Ask yourself during your day to day, am I thinking from the version of me that I desire to be? Would the me that I desire to be thinking these things? Would he or she be saying these things? Would they be doing these actions? Would they be having these reactions? And if the answer is no, then you need to adjust accordingly. You need to make sure that you are persistent in thinking from your desire, thinking from the place of already having what it is that you want. Even if your 3D is showing you all of the opposite, all of the crap that you don't want to hear, all of the things that you don't want to deal with, you need to still occupy that end scene. You need to still occupy the state of the wish fulfilled. And this is something that needs to be a consistent until you really start to notice that inner change. And I'm going to give you guys another fun example as to what exactly I mean by this. And this will hopefully help you see the difference between thinking of something and thinking from something. I want you guys to imagine a lemon. See the picture of a lemon in your mind, right? Can you see it? Okay, now I want you to actually, in your imagination, hold that lemon and feel that texture, feel that bumpy texture, and smell the citrus. And I want you to take a knife and cut that lemon in half. Notice that sweet citrus smell as you cut it open. Can you feel those senses? Can you already feel your mouth watering from that sour and get those crazy sensations? Do you notice the difference? Thinking of the lemon, you just had a picture of a piece of fruit in your mind. But when you were actually cutting that lemon and holding it in your imagination, your mouth naturally started to water as you got that puckery sensation going on from like the sour juice. You felt the ridges, you smelled that citrus. When you begin to get your senses involved in it and really start to play with it, you are going to naturally have those reactions. Even though you're not holding a lemon or cutting a lemon, thinking from the place of already having that lemon was enough to set off a bunch of the senses. And you really got to experience that lemon just from the place of imagining that you have it. This is the difference between a daydream and an imaginal act. So remember that when you go into your scene, that you are actually bringing those feeling and those senses with you. You are invoking them to the very best of your ability, and you are conjuring up those feelings that would come naturally if you were living that desired scene now. You are not picturing something in the future. You are not picturing something for the sake of getting it. You don't want to ever go in with the mindset of, if I visualize this thing, I'm going to get it. I have to visualize this thing to get it down the line. No. Actually step in and embody it. Become it. Feel yourself as the person that you desire to be right here and right now, and that is where the magic happens. And you can tell if you were on the right track from noting your day-to-day thoughts and noting the day-to-day conversations that you're carrying. If you notice that during the day you have fallen off the bandwagon or that your thoughts are not what you desire, it's not coming from a place of what you desire to experience, then make sure to go back. Go back to that scene, go back to that feeling, go back to imagining that you are already the version of you that you desire to be. So anyways, guys, I hope this helped. If it did, do not forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in checking out any of my other resources, I will link them down below, including one-on-one coaching, my blog, and my social channels. So definitely be sure to check them out. And be sure to check out these videos over here. Each video is a different topic, but they all pertain in how to manifest the very best life possible. So until next time, you guys, take care, be well, and never forget to live that desire as if it's happening right now. This will take you anywhere you want to go. Happy manifesting.